Yo, welcome to Yap. Hey, Kola and Tumsime here. Hey, Banange, thanks for following me on Facebook. I have a lot of people who like me on Facebook who keep on, they keep on selling me statistics on Facebook which don't even make sense. This is a show called Reliable Nonsense. If honestly, listen to this show and the things that are said on this show actually move your feelings, maybe you're the nonsense. What is happening in Uganda? A lot of things going around. There's a lot of news about Banange. Kadaga wants a chopper. Apparently, she's tired of traffic jam. Andrew Mwenda is still crushing on Besigye. What's with that, man? Mwenda is saying that FDC guys are extremists. Yet every day he wakes up in the morning, he doesn't think of morning sex, he doesn't think of breakfast, he thinks of writing an article about Besigye. Mwenda is now the extremist. He said that Mayao, every time you attack the FDC extremists, that they character assassinate you. This commander doesn't know what assassination means, man. We need to come to your place and we beat you up. You know, I sympathize with Mwenda. You see, Bambi has a bald head. Eh? Can you believe having no hair in this sun? There's no AC. So, Kati, Bambi, every time the sun hits and sinks in, Bambi, a chunker in your memory. But it's okay, we understand. Dude, move on with your life. Uganda is becoming one of the fun places. Rebecca Kadaga. Now, this is the ultimate story of success. Rebecca Kadaga wants a chopper. She's tired of taxis, pioneer bus, and her V8 over V10 over V8. You know those big cars which take like 5 liters of fuel per second. She wants a chopper. That is the ultimate success story. A woman who came from making chapati and now she's being flown over seeing chapati makers. That's a success story. Apparently, everyone is complaining. She's going to spend 19.9 billion. Oh, okay, it's not, of course, you know, we don't even know. Apparently, some people said that's not what she said. You know, the media, some people say that's not what she said. Others say that that's what she said. Others say that she dreamt about it and the dream leaked in the public. But anyway, you get the idea. Kadaga, there is a rumor that they need to get for her a helicopter. They are calling it an Airbus. An Airbus HEC. When they said Airbus, I thought it was going to be a big thing. It sits on the 9 passengers. That's not an Airbus. That's an Air VTs or something. That's a chopper. From 2000, they're going to buy it for Kadaga. Now, apparently, politicians are trying to complain that. I want Duncan Abigaba, actually. Duncan Abigaba, I called you to come on this show and you didn't come. Duncan Abigaba brought in controversy because he posted that Kadaga doesn't need a chopper, that she needs a V8, that it can fly her to her district. We know you've never been in a plane, but a car doesn't fly. A car uses road transport. That's the whole concept of having a car and a chopper. Eh? But anyway, seriously, think about it. This is what I think, honestly. As a person, I think they should let Kadaga have the chopper. Yeah, they should let her. Because even if, honestly, they don't allocate 19.9 billion for Kadaga, still that money will be wasted. And it's not only Kadaga who's wasting government's money. We all know these motherfuckers are epic. They are wasteful. Every other thing I do is about spending money. Let me first go through some of the money that an MP is entitled to. Just an MP. And when you say MP, we don't mean an extraordinary person. We mean Katolo Gwama. This is the money that he's always expecting. This guy, apparently, they earn between an MP 20 to 25 million in consolidated pay. One-off car grant of 103 million. Are you hearing the money? Wardrobe grant, Ngoyi, or 50 million just to buy panty, what, stockings, 50 million. 2.6 million for an iPad. 4.5 million mileage facilitation. 2.6 million subsistence allowance. 500,000 mitwara tano per sitting, that's an allowance. 1 million allowance every time an MP travels, 1 million. On top of that, 1 million allowance every time they travel abroad. Every day they are out, they get an allowance of 1.75 million. And every time they are doing an inline travel, it's 150,000. Just one MP. Do you know how many MPs you have? You have 238 MPs. So you people, you're wasteful. Stop trying to show off on Kadaga. Me, I told you, the money in Uganda is up for grabs. If you join the parliament, you've gone to steal, kill, and destroy this country. That's what you guys do. So instead of blaming Kadaga, come up with some better plan. Like for me, I've always argued. Instead of saying that MPs should not get cars, and you put the money aside and you use it and you give it to your daughters to go on vacation, you support them, let them get the cars. When they finally get the cars, you get the cars from them and donate them to Mulago. At least in that way, something good will have happened. That's the same approach you should use for Kadaga's chopper. You let her buy the chopper. When she finally buys the chopper, and at least we are sure that that money was not stolen, 19.9 billion. Of course, the chopper is not that much. Yeah. That's an old chopper. But of course, in Uganda, you know how it works. It will be like half that money, then the other money will just go to other people. I don't want to mention. Just make sure she gets the chopper. When she finally gets the chopper, donate it to Mulago. And just like that, leave the woman to walk on the streets. Kadaga, why would Kadaga even be in a chopper? This is a lady who is traveling in a V8. She needs to stop in Wayogere and bargain for Rolex. Kadimota demu chopper. She'll be asking you where is the stage when we bargain in the chopper. She doesn't even know what. Jesus freaking Christ, leave her in a V8. Cut us the crap. So, Dagan, the next time you want to attack Kadaga, please make sure that you don't think when your head is confused. First, go to the bathroom, sit down, relax, get some lotion, relax. Yeah. Then make constructive argument.